Hello, Emily.
Hello, Emily.
Right, so you don't work in HRC anymore. You work in NDRI. Can you tell us what that stands for and a little bit about your work?
Certainly. So NDRI is National Development and Research Institutes. And so that's the organization that I work for, but I work on a research study that's funded by the National Institutes of Health. And the research study that I'm working on is investigating hepatitis C treatment among active drug users. So we're looking at a certain model, a multidisciplinary model for working with active drug users to provide hepatitis C treatment, where we provide a whole bunch of other resources, including mental health support, case management, intensive case management, medical services, and we integrate all of that care so that we're providing all of the services and working with people really intensively to help them get through hepatitis C treatment successfully. And the reason that this is important to us is because, unfortunately, active drug users, who are the people who most often are impacted by hepatitis C, most often have hepatitis C, and it's most important that they actually get treatment for hepatitis C, are the people who are excluded most often from treatment. So lots of times doctors don't want to give people treatment for hepatitis C if they're actively using drugs. And we want to say, look, active drug users can be really successful on treatment. Actually, people who have a history of taking drugs are often really good at taking drugs. But sometimes you might need to provide some other support and some other services to make it possible for them to be as successful on treatment. So we're doing this research study. It's a control trial, which means we have one group of people who are going to be getting all of these extra services and one group of people who are going to be getting the kinds of services that they would get in the community normally. And we're comparing them to say, okay, are these people more successful if you provide all of these services and actually work to talk to people and figure out what needs they need met? And so that's the study that we're doing. And I'm working as a project director, so I'm kind of overseeing things a little bit, but I used to work on a research study also about hepatitis C. And I think it's important work.
Okay, so can you explain a little bit about hepatitis C, like, how many people a year get it and stuff like that?
Ooh, I don't know if I'm going to be really good on the numbers. I know that in the US, I think the estimates right now are at least 5 million people have hepatitis C in the US. Those numbers more than likely are really low, because the people who have hepatitis C, one, because people haven't been tested a lot of times for hepatitis C, and then also, when the numbers are being collected about who has hepatitis C and the statistics are being collected, oftentimes they're being collected with the people that are most available. So the people who are going to their doctor regularly, or the people collecting the statistics have access to. And what we know is that the people who are most likely to have hepatitis C might be homeless. They might not have had a great experience going to the doctor in the past because of stigma and discrimination related to their drug use. And so those people aren't actually even being counted. And so we don't know exactly how many people have hepatitis C. I would say probably between 5 million and 8 million people in the US have hepatitis C. And I think what we're gonna find also, because hepatitis C is a really slow acting virus, so people get it, they don't always know that they're infected, and they don't feel sick right away, and so they think, okay, I'm good, I don't need to worry about this. But what we're gonna find is that now, in the coming years, people who've been sick for 10, 15, 20 years and have had hepatitis C and have been dealing with it, they're gonna start getting sick more quickly now, and it's gonna become more urgent that we really figure out a good way to start talking about hepatitis C and to be dealing with hepatitis C, particularly among drug users. Because in the past, what has happened is HIV was dealt with pretty aggressively after the community was, showed some outrage and pushed the authorities to really deal with HIV. And so we did well, actually, addressing HIV in the community. But unfortunately, hepatitis C is different enough from HIV that the messages that were being used to prevent HIV and to encourage people to take care of themselves and prevent HIV, those messages didn't work quite as well for hepatitis C. And so now we're in this routine and we need to sort of rethink things a little bit and relearn new ways to start really tackling hepatitis C, because I think it's already a huge problem and it's just going to become more important that we deal with it soon.
Okay, so how can people help NDRI?
How can they help NDRI? Well, NDRI is doing okay on its own. I think they can help NDRI, and they can help our work, and they can help in general by thinking about the ways that drug use is talked about, that drug use is thought about, the way that people who use drugs are treated, and I think in general, by focusing a little bit more attention on hepatitis C and the issues that are facing people who use drugs, and thinking about ways that we can really increase access to treatment for hepatitis C, the way that we can improve relationships between doctors and drug users, so that the kind of important conversations around drug use and hepatitis C and hepatitis C prevention, that those conversations are happening and people feel comfortable to talk about any sort of medical issues that they might be having or struggles that they're having or questions that they have about hepatitis C. I think that would be helpful. And in turn, that would help NDRI and our work, because well, then we could research other things, because everyone would be getting treatment for hepatitis C.
Okay, so why do you think that doctors are unfair sort of on the patients using drugs?
It's a big question. Unfortunately, I think the easiest answer is that doctors live in the world, and unfortunately, society at large has some preconceived ideas about people who use drugs, and there's a lot of stigma towards people who use drugs. And unfortunately, doctors don't often receive a lot of training or a lot of support around thinking differently about people who use drugs. And so unfortunately, those stereotypes and ideas that might have been conditioned, or they might have learned as they were growing up, or they might have learned from the government, or they might have learned from the way that people talk about drugs and drug use, they haven't been challenged. And doctors have a lot of power, actually, in a lot of ways. And so they have this opportunity to sort of perpetuate that stigma. And I think that, you know, it's an easy answer to say stigma and discrimination, and like doctors stereotype and pay too much attention to the stereotypes rather than looking at the people and thinking about each individual as having just as much potential as anyone else.
Has anybody been like rude to you because of the kind of job that you do?
That's a good question. I don't know if people have been rude to me. I mean, so I've been doing this work for a long time. So, and before working at the study, which I've only been there for a couple of months, actually, I was at HRC and doing a lot of work around drugs and drug use here, and then before that I was working with younger injection drug users, and there were times that I would go with drug users to the doctors to see their medical providers or to the emergency room, and I would advocate on their behalf. And in those cases, people were certainly rude. They were rude to me, they were rude to the person who was using drugs, so I've certainly experienced that. I think the thing that is maybe even harder for me directly is that sometimes I feel like I can't be honest and really talk openly with everyone about the work that I do, about the reason that I do this work, about the ways in which the work is personal to me and has had an impact on my life. And I think in that sense, it's not like they're being rude directly to me, but sort of by making it And it could also be my own sort of internalization or my own fear of how people are going to respond if I'm talking about the work that I'm doing. I think, though, that that's the thing that the way that I've had an impact the most is that sometimes I feel a little nervous to really be honest or to talk about the work that I do or why it's important to me because of the stigma that exists around drugs and drug use. But mostly I just say that's their issue.